CHNOPS are the most common elements in living organisms. Carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur. These elements make up 98% of living matter on Earth. Why should you study CHNOPS? If you understand the chemical behavior of these six elements, you'll understand almost all of biochemical reactions. CHNOPS make up 99.7% of bacteria, and they make up 97.9% of humans. It takes just four elements, oxygen, carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen, to make up 96.2% of humans. Let's start with carbon. Carbon is about 18% of humans by mass. We say Earth has carbon-based life forms. Why do we say that? Because of the carbon backbone. Carbon makes up the skeleton of most biological molecules, including proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, and nucleic acids. Carbon has four valence electrons. This lets it make a variety of bonds. Four single bonds, two double bonds, a single bond and a triple bond. So as a result, you can make lots of different stable structures. Imagine if we were talking about Legos or Tinker Toys. If you can join together pieces in four different ways, you could make a lot more structures than something with only one connection or two connections. Silicon has similar chemical behavior. It also has four valence electrons. So maybe we might find a planet one day that had a slightly different start in life and wound up with silicon-based life forms. Now, hydrogen. Hydrogen makes up about 10% of humans. We find hydrogen in water, H2O, so it's not surprising it makes up so much of living matter. We're about 60% water. Some organisms are as much as 90% water. We'll address this idea, how vital water is to life, in another video. Hydrogen is especially active in its ionic form, H+. Acids increase H+ concentration, while bases decrease H+ concentration. So, hydrogen plays an important part in acid-base behavior, which is involved in a lot of biochemical reactions. Nitrogen. This is an essential component of DNA. Think of those nitrogenous bases that make up the rungs of the DNA ladder. Also, be on the lookout for nitrogen in amine groups, like on the ends of amino acids. These amine groups confer basic, as opposed to acidic, behavior. Nitrogen makes up about 3% of humans. Nitrogen is also especially abundant in the air that we breathe, about 78%. Oxygen. Oxygen is also found in water, H2O, so you'd expect a lot of oxygen in living matter. Oxygen makes up about 65% by mass of the human body. We also breathe oxygen, O2. In chemistry, oxygen is important in oxidizing reactions. It's going to grab electrons and become negatively charged. Some people think antioxidants are important to slow down our internal oxidizing, or rusting, if you will. Phosphorus is found in the backbone of DNA. Remember, the backbone goes sugar phosphate, sugar phosphate. We also find those phosphate groups in ATP, which is the key form of energy currency in biochemical reactions. Phosphorylation and dephosphorylation events are really important in biochemistry. This is often used as a signal or as a trigger for conformational changes in biological molecules. We also find phosphates in phospholipids, which are an important part of cell membranes. Phosphorus makes up about 1% of humans. And finally, sulfur. Sulfur is found in two amino acids, cysteine and methionine. You'll learn that amino acids string together to form proteins, and these are two of the 20 amino acids. The sulfurs from these amino acids tend to bind together, forming disulfide bridges. This is part of what holds a folded protein together in its final 3D shape. A few organisms use selenium instead of sulfur, but for most organisms, it's a fundamental part of what makes us. 0.25% of humans are sulfur. Another significant element for humans is calcium. Calcium makes up 1.5% of the human body, almost all of it found in mineral compounds, in bones and teeth. But its chemical behavior as an ion is where we see its most dramatic functions, acting, for instance, in neuron signaling and muscle contraction. All the elements used in very small amounts are called trace elements. These include iron, we need that for hemoglobin, sodium and potassium, important as electrolytes, those are used in signaling and neuron function, iodine, that's needed for your thyroid hormones. I think the details of all the trace elements probably belong in their own video. Next, we'll look at how these elements interact with each other, forming bonds and making the great variety of biochemical molecules. Here's a challenge for you. Name a biological molecule that contains only the elements in CHNOPS. For example, any given sugar is made of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, like glucose, C6H12O6. Your job is to find another molecule containing only CHNOPS, or a subset of those elements, and write it in the comments. If you have something else you'd like to talk about, write it in the comments as well. Keep it clean, and let's focus on the science. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and share it with your friends. Post it on Reddit. Twitter it. That's how we grow as a channel. You can get even more friendly with Socratica by joining our Patreon team. Patreon lets you support your favorite creators for as little as $1 a month. It's a huge help for us to make more videos, and it really lets us know you're with us. Thank you.